Hi, I'm Regina Murphy, and I'm thrilled that you're all here for the class. I want to talk about what led me to be here today. Okay, so I'm going to start with I was a massage therapist. I was working at the St. Therese Center for HIV and AIDS, and I was starting to bleed a lot and didn't stop for 9 months, and I knew that I needed to figure something out. But right at that time, this is 2001, I was also going to see my niece in a play a block away from the World Trade Center, and the night of the performance was September 10th, and I was staying at the Marriott World Trade Center. At the last minute, my son said he wouldn't come with us. It was David and I that were going to go, and my daughter said, I want to go, Mom. I'm taking his place, but I can't be there on that day. Can we move it to the Friday instead of the Monday night? And I said, never going to happen. Delta doesn't change things when blah, blah, blah. So naturally, this tiny little theater off Broadway, they're about the size of this room. They were able to get us 5 tickets on the Friday night instead of the Monday night. My airline changed it. Everything was perfect. And I went with my daughter instead of my son and my husband. And as soon as I set foot into the World Trade Center, it went from having my period to full-blown hemorrhaging. And when I got back, I had to go see Dr. Fuller Royal. I was bleeding to death, and basically he did a vol test, and on the heart rate variability, I was a 16, which is in the area of sudden death. So he did this ridiculous thing called tapping. Does anybody know what tapping is? Okay, well, if you don't know what tapping is, that's a big part of all healing, in my humble opinion. So he did this ridiculous tapping, and I went home, and all of the bleeding had stopped after 9 months. I did think he was out of his mind with this tapping thing. This is 2001, so we know what happened on September 11th. The buildings came down. My brother-in-law was in the building. So it was very traumatic. But once I saw Fuller Royal, the tapping, all the bleeding stopped. Now, some people think maybe I was allergic to gunpowder. Other people think it might have been just the energy had already set in, the great sadness that was coming to the building. But there was also a sadness going on in my life. I had a perfect life. I lived on the lake. I had a job that I loved, but something was happening in the background. So I was pushing it down, and that sadness was what actually caused the bleeding. And so once I was tapped on, and a new program was kind of put in place, the bleeding stopped and I began to recover. From that moment on, I became a tapping maniac. I had an aura camera. I could see what was happening in the tapping. I could see what was happening when the belief changes came. It was absolutely astounding. I had the best aura camera on the planet. So that was the beginning, was energy psychology. So I went to teach a class. And I have this huge, amazing mansion up in Mount Charleston, and I was gifted the time and space to teach a class. 65 people were coming, and I got up about 4 days, maybe 5 days before the class, and I tried to get out of bed, but I couldn't. I had a lower back issue to the point where I had to slide out of the bed. And I knew that there was a doctor who had written the tapping sequences for very specific things. His name was Dr. Ebert. So he actually had the lower sacrum tapping sequence, which was a 30-minute sequence that needed to be done twice a day. Well, I did it at the computer. I got there and sat there, and I was able to crawl then to the couch instead of slide. And I had printed out his whole book, and I saw on the side that it said Accutone CDs. I am as lazy as you could possibly be. So I thought, if I don't have to tap, I could just play a CD. This is too wonderful. So I ordered the CD. Not knowing there was an antenna to go in, it was in the envelope, but I don't read instructions, which is how I managed to invent things, by not reading instructions. So I put it on very low, because it was these frequencies that went okay, they were horrible. So I put it really low, and I get up the next morning, and I couldn't even lift my wine. That's how bad this lower back thing was. The next morning, gone. Completely gone after playing this. He overnighted it to me, and I was able to hold the class. I was so fine. But the best part was, even though my son's room was way, 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 way down the hall and could not have heard those frequencies, in my humble opinion, and he is like the grumpiest kid on the planet. He woke up like he was the Pillsbury Doughboy. This was clear, a very clear change. So that was the beginning of me understanding the power of sound frequencies.